we are celebrating the companionship of being together as one family from various parts of the world. And so I will not give you my usual homily for weddings. But I was very much touched by the responsorial psalm, "The Lord is compassionate and gracious." And in my other Bible, which I read on the phone, it says, "The Lord is compassionate and love." So God is full of love for us, for his people. God is love. And when we look back from the time we came here, one of the things that still continues to be emphasized by the different lectures we have, and also especially in the retreat, the love of God for me, I continue seeing that in my experience here, in the sources that we are going through. What is this love of God that is for me? And then I look back today, reflecting on Africa, and I say, I think the love of God for me is the place where he brought me up. In that rural village of Kurude in Zimbabwe, farming area, where I grew up swimming in the river, like River Kalunde. When I look at it, I think of the river that I used to swim when I was very young. Playing in the fields, sometimes eating cattle. I was privileged enough that my father was a farmer, so he had some people helping him, but on certain days we had to do the work. And I think the love of God for each and every one of us comes through where we were brought up and how we were brought up. Somewhere in there is that love of God. And when we think of the continent of Africa, no matter what comes, are the sufferings and the nasty things that we see on TV, and some people may find it difficult to wonder, is there anything good in that continent? And I was once told by someone when I was studying in France, I was just finishing my experience, and I was looking forward to going back home. And this friend of mine said, "You seriously going back to Africa?" You know, to Zimbabwe in particular, because we were having a crisis. And I said, "Yes, I'm looking forward to going back." They said, "Why? You know, you can just stay here." I said, "Well, I'm a Jesuit for studies. But I love my home, and I know there's no food in the shops, there's suffering and all that, but that's my home. And besides that, there is a lot of goodness in it." So I think God, in his compassion and his love and mercy, he gives us this love, even though we may have some sufferings. And looking at the first reading, we hear of people like John. You know what he went through? Lot of suffering, but he remained faithful to his God. So experiencing suffering does not in any way mean that God doesn't love us. He loves us in our very own situation and circumstances. And that is why today I'm very joyous because we're celebrating who we are, irrespective of the sufferings and the difficulties. And I want to say to us, we have challenges within our lives. In our families, some of us come from broken families. But within them, the love of God is present. And maybe we are here today to be energized with that love, so that we can be sent back to our homes where there is that brokenness. And the love that we experience here will mend, will heal, will be there to touch the people. So my prayer today is that let us all remain touched by the love of God. Let us continue touching each other here, so that when we go back home, where there are sufferings, where there are grumblings, as we hear in the first reading, where there are difficulties, where there are challenges, whatever they may be,